I'm in my 60s now, and I just feel that all my life I did all the kabair sins, and I can feel all the consequences happening now around me. And I keep doing tawbah, but I don't know what is the way out, because I just feel that I'm repeating a lot of the sins I did, and I can't make up for how do I go about it? Like, it's missed fast Ramadan, riba, lies, nifaq. So, I know it's the qadr of Allah. I keep telling myself it's the qadr of Allah.
Allah al-musta'an. May Allah make it easy for you, sister. First of all, Allah has stated in the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal, وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Who forgive and pardon the sins except Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who forgive the sins. Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who accept the repentance. Allah stated in the Quran, قابل التوب. Allah is the one who accept the repentance. Allah Azza wa Jal, غافر الذنب, is the one who forgive the sins. So that's why, my sister, if you truly repented to Allah Azza wa Jal, if you truly sincerely repented to Allah Azza wa Jal, you have to fulfill the conditions of repentance. Firstly, to stop the evil deed, meaning not to do it again. And to plan not to do it again, meaning you don't stop the evil deed and plan to do it the next day. You mean you plan not to do it again, as if you want to do it again, as if you're going to be thrown in the hellfire. And as well, seeking forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jal sincerely. And as well, follow the evil deeds with righteous deeds. To try your best, inshallah ta'ala, to seek forgiveness from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And as well, I advise you to go Hajj. And as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the one who goes Hajj and Mabroor, that Allah Azza wa Jal will expiate all the sins, and the person will come back maghfurul lah, that all his sins is pardoned. So try, inshallah ta'ala, to do Hajj, plan to do Hajj next year, and prepare for it. Free yourself from all haram. From now, repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. Ask Allah forgiveness. Prepare yourself for the next Ramadan. Next Ramadan, do fast the month of Ramadan, as the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever fasted the month of Ramadan out of faith in Allah Azza wa Jal and fearing the accountability in the day of judgment, Allah will expiate all his sins. Do Qiyam al-Layl in the month of Ramadan, from now until the month of Ramadan. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whoever did Qiyam al-Layl in the nights of Ramadan, Allah will expiate all his sins or her sins. And as well, my sister, if you missed some fasting in the past, try to do as many days, voluntary days of fasting, as much as you can. Fast Mondays and Thursdays. Fast every 3 nights, every lunar calendar month, 13th, 14th, 15th. Try to do that. Donate for the sake of Allah. Give sadaqat for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. And the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the sadaqah, that it will, subhanallah, it will stop the anger of Allah Azza wa Jal, just like the water stopped the fire. So try to do that, my sister. This is the thing that you can do, inshallah ta'ala. And be sincere to make dua for yourself, that Allah to forgive you and to pardon you. And seek forgiveness for the Muslims, all the Muslims. For every single Muslim that you make dua for, Allah Azza wa Jal make an angel to make dua for you to forgive your sins. So you say, oh Allah, forgive all the Muslims in Islam, all the Muslims, the one who passed away and the one who's still alive and the one who yet to come. Forgive them, pardon them. Ask Allah forgiveness for them, and Allah Azza will retain this back to you as a dua from the angel for in behalf of every single person that you made dua for. That's the way, inshallah ta'ala, for expiation of the sins, and asking for and to be sincerely repenting to Allah Azza wa Jal, and asking the pleasure of Allah Azza wa Jal. Is that clear, my sister? May Allah make it easy for you, sister, and may Allah help you. and make it easy for you. And if you have any question, inshallah, you could call us back, inshallah ta'ala. What you said touched my heart, subhanAllah, because we are all sinner. Allahi, we are all sinners. And Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who hides our sins. We are all sinners. We are all away from, we don't deserve, Allah. If we think about ourselves, we don't deserve anything good happens to us. But Allah Azza wa Jal encompasses us with His mercy and His forgiveness. And Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who expiates our sins. Otherwise, Wallahi, if, as the scholars used to say, if the sins, subhanAllah, has a smell, Wallahi, no one will be even standing even to be look at us. But Allah Azza wa Jal encompasses with his sitter, hides our sins, and Allah Azza wa Jal forgive our sins. May Allah forgive us and you. Jazakallah khair, sister.